When Madame Pompadour was on a ballroom floor, said all the gentlemen obviously.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Fallout 4 Playthrough.
Excuse me, got a moment? So, how do you feel about the Commonwealth going forward?
Why the hell would things start getting better now?
That's so. Well, thank you again for taking the time.
She's, still a reporter, I guess. Anyways.
The Minutemen are looking out. Glad someone would come.
We're gonna go into the dugout because, well, I have a mission to actually request. Actually, get done there. Well, confidence man. Exactly. That's what it's all about. So, what do we have?
So, did you have any luck with that photo?
I guess I'm speaking to this person here.
If you're hungry, we sell food. But usually people just order drinks.
I don't think I'm here for that.
Not interested.
Fine.
Miss?
Oh, hello again. I can take your order whenever you're ready.
Well, maybe it's...
Who owns this bar, anyway?
The Bobrock brothers picked this place up a few years ago. Vadim Bobrock is the loud one, and Yefim Bobrock is the quiet one. And I'm the one that has to listen to the market. Like sable
coats and wedding rings. Okay.
Not now.
Alright.
Good to know.
That's right.
So don't you say I'm yes, the long distance. Off of where it's supposed to be. Maybe it's on another floor. Okay. Baby, you got the cutest. There.
Okay, let us get down to brass tacks.
I am glad you are willing to come. Unlike my deadbeat brother,
Travis is a good guy. He deserves a better life. Greet the sun
every morning.
So, what did you have in mind? I'm gonna need some more in the way of details.
Ever been in bar fight?
I can hold my own, if that's what you mean.
This one's a pretty tough cookie.
Exactly what I mean. I want you to back up Travis in his first fight.
I want to stage fight here in Dutch. Nothing too serious. We make sure Travis wins and feels good about himself after.
I want you to be there to help make it look real. What do you think? Sound good to you?
Yeah.
I'm on board. When do we start?
Why not soon as possible?
I have contacts. People like Encounter. Real tough look. But they will take a dive for mine.
They confront Travis here at Doug.
You step in and give him who she needs to stand up to. Then you and Travis take them down. Nothing gets too rough.
And Travis is something he can feel good about.
Simple. Right? I have everything ready by 6 o'clock.
Travis should be here by then. You show up and it will go well. Promise!
So did you have any luck with that phone?
Okay, I guess I just beat them back here. Pardon me. 6 p.m. I'm just gonna double check. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna do.
You seen the wall lately? It's freaking cool.
Yeah, I see the wall. It's not bad.
You ain't gonna last once you leave the wall, so don't get you.
Well, I guess this will give me a chance to,
You. Well, I suppose we can do business.
All right.
Well, I've got a few minutes to browse.
Odds and ends.
Until then, yeah. You know, profit. Profit's a thing.
When the Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian red to yes, then I suppose anything goes. When Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Max Gordon produce his show, anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, and that gent today, you gave a cent today, won that several chateau. When folks who still can ride in jitneys find out Vanderbilt's and Whitney's black baby clothes, anything goes. When Sam Goldwyn can with great conviction instruct Anna's man addiction, then Anna goes. Anything goes.
Hey there, General. Just bringing good news to Diamond City.
Alright, well. See some of the progress of me on anything goes. Perhaps. Just think of those trucks you got, and those tops you got, decorated, and those you got from those shoes you got, and those paints you got, and anything you got from those radios. So it's just a kind of grease through. Can broadcast event from them and cause pranks to those spots. Anything goes. General stuff that we need. But, yeah. Disperse. Yeah. So. We'll have to see what the time it is. It's gonna get it close to that time. Close. Well, I'm gonna jump on this ahead. Just a little bit. All right. Can't do minutes, damn it. All right, well. Make our way home for there, at least.
City Free Shopping, right here.
Sea monster in the harbor. True what they're saying? It was some kind of something.
Yep. It sure was. Alright. Well. Let's kind of hang in here, I guess, a little bit. For a couple minutes. It's a little bit 6. Well, I hope you're enjoying all that I am making and creating here. I know I've changed my format just slightly in the episodes. So far, I've noticed
self-prescribed camp have recommended by me, myself, and I.
The next thing that I should be doing will be Far Harbor. So I'm gonna start that up. Probably the beginning of October. Just to let you all know. Here we are, it's 6 p.m.
Yeah.
And if that's the first thing I'm supposed to be kind of working with. Alright.
What's this about?
Oh, what's wrong? Not so tough once you're not on the air.
Yeah!
Hey there,
pal. Maybe I like your little radio program. What do you have to say about that?
Everything okay here?
Does it look okay? Because... no. It is not.
I have no idea what I did to deserve this. I just wish they'd go away.
Come on, man. Take a stand. Don't chicken out here.
I don't think I could do that. Thing that you're describing. With these men, it could, well, it could turn out. Folks, the happiest way back
home. Don't know why I left the homestead. Don't worry. I've got your back.
Well, if you think it would work,
we're right behind you.
Okay, that's... well... that's enough.
Oh, I'm sorry. You say something.
I said, that's enough. Leave me alone.
Look at you. Let me think about that for a second. Nah, I don't think so.
I mean it. Leave me alone.
Sounds like you were thinking about saying, or else. Were you, Travis? Were you gonna say... or else. I'm wondering
hey there,
what comes
pal.
After that. What you gonna do, little man?
I'll beat you up!
Big mistake, Travis. I'm gonna destroy you and your friend here.
Oh, it's you.
Get lost.
Beat it, hell!
I wonder if this is normal for other journalists.
I really must confess.
Well, I guess you can show it again.
Travis.
Oh, jeez.
That I have overheard from two people. Is the spreadiest
wine is the headiest. Okay, well.
Yeah.
Oh, whatever it is, keep it to yourself. Better that way.
Okay, not quite what I expected, but we move on. Ready for the next part of Foolproof Plan?
There's a foolproof plan.
Depends on what it is.
He's nice and steep.
You have seen Scarlet, yes? She has worked here for some time. Now, I am just simple Bob, but I see things. I see how Travis looks. And I see that sometimes she looks at him. If someone who was not her employer suggests that she go spend time with Travis, it might do him some good.
I could have a chat with him.
Yes, I know. This is why I'm telling you. Just do whatever it takes to get her to agree to see Travis, and this will all be worth it. You and I never talked about this, all right? I feel so welcome
each time that I return. It seems somewhat noble, I guess. My keeps laughing like a clown. I love those
days. So did you have any luck with that photo?
Yes, it's the next part of the rest is out here. From Friday till Monday,
that's how the weekend yeah?
No. I've got a dream house, I'll
build there one day with picket fence and... Park the car in the yard? How about I handle you in the heart with a haymaker?
Yes. That my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown. Like a clown, I love those dear hearts. Okay, it's strange. People live and love in Barcode.
Scarlet.
I'm on a break right now.
Dear hearts and gentle people who live.
Actually, I'd like to talk to you about Travis, if you have a moment.
Travis? Really? Did he mention me? I heard about the fight. Travis was... Well, he was brave.
Yeah. Absolutely. You should really pay him a visit.
You think? I mean, I've definitely noticed him. Maybe... No, I couldn't just go over there.
Look, Travis is a nice guy. I can tell that you like him. And I think he likes you. Just go talk to him.
Okay, I will. I'll go see him now. Thanks.
Good deed done for the day. Oh, sorry. Move it, iBot. Out of the way. I got important things here to do.
You'll be pleased to hear that Mr.
I'll be pleased to hear what. I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Too good, busy racing around.
Even though I'm a doctor, I admit I have a small vice. A quick drink.
Terrible. I knew it. He was up to no good, and look what's happened now. You've got to help. I can't do it. You've got to help me.
Help you do what?
What are you talking about?
I am talking about Vadim. They took him. Those men, the ones that messed with Travis, they came back. Said Vadim owed them money, that they had a deal. He wouldn't pay, and that they grabbed him and said that they would make him pay. And then they just dragged him out.
You have to do something. Please tell me you can do something.
Yeah.
I'll bring him back, Yefim. Count on it.
Please, just bring him back. He's an idiot, but he's my brother. I'd go with you, but someone has to stay here. Talk to Travis. Maybe he knows where they took him.
Okay, now I gotta go talk to Travis. That seems like a lot running around. Just saying. For a guy I barely know. This is a little bit long. West. Not count.
Hey, no shame in taking it.
Okay. Yeah, someone else is kind of bad.
I'm not supposed to talk to people I don't know.
Okay, so don't talk to me. Oh. I do believe this is Scarlet. I shouldn't interrupt anything, I don't think. Well, we just give it a few minutes. It's just, I don't know. It would be...
The Minutemen are there now! That's good. Yeah.
Yeah, well. Maybe I'll just give everybody a look at oh my god. Sweetheart, I guess I remember this. A kiss that a dream on. Well, it sort of looks like that, yeah. A kiss before you leave me. In my imagination. He's a Minuteman. One thing before we part. So, a kiss to build the dream. That's what he looks like. I think we can tweet it. Cool. We'll talk to Travis.
What's going on?
Travis, where'd you go? I'll be with you. Let's see.
Have you seen Vadim? He was grabbed at the dugout. And Yefim thought you might know where Bull took him.
That's not a funny joke. Like at all.
Your lips for just a moment.
I'm not joking around, Travis. This is serious. I really do need your help.
Wait. Really?
Oh man, wow, is this... This is because of what happened, isn't it? It's my fault.
Not your fault.
No, Travis, this is between Vadim and those men. It's not your fault.
But if I hadn't gotten into that fight with them, maybe this wouldn't have happened.
Don't do that to yourself. All we can do now is figure out how to make this work.
Look, I don't really...
I don't have a lot of friends. If Vadim is missing, or in trouble, or whatever,
then I'm gonna help get him back.
Alright.
Alright. I'd welcome the help.
Good. I didn't want to have to argue about it with you. I've heard enough to know they'll probably hold up at the old Beantown Brewery. We gotta go in there, show them we mean business, and then we can bring Vadim back, and everything will be okay. Right? I'll get a gun, and I'll meet you there. We'll settle this.
Alright, wow.
I'm on a break right now.
Okay. Good to know. So I guess we're gonna settle this one out at the old Beantown Brewery. However that is. So I think it's probably time to get a weapon ready. Calvert is here. Fix things up. Don't time fly here.
If he wants them out.
Hopefully they don't have guns drawn.
Crazy calls me.
Yeah, it looks like.
Sure, I'm crazy.
We'll have to fix things up here.
Oh, thank God. You're here. So this is it.
Odds are, if they've got Vadim, he's inside. We're gonna be okay, right?
Crazy
yeah.
Just keep a cool head, okay? Don't think about it too much.
Okay, right. Sure. Yeah.
And we'll all walk out of this in one place.
Any last-minute advice? I've never done anything like this.
Yeah, I'd stay behind me.
I go in first, and you stay behind me. Watch my back.
Okay. Whatever you say.
Probably safer that way.
I say I'll care forever. And I mean forever. If I have to hold up the sky. That shakes the bough. He moves me with a smile. The difficult.
What the?
I'll do.
Whatever is making that smell needs to seek medical attention immediately.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Thank you. I didn't know if anyone would come. I thought perhaps this is the end. Thank you. Thank you. You are a true friend.
You're welcome, Vadim. We weren't going to leave you to these guys.
You are a good man. These idiots had caps and chems just lying around. They did not notice when I filled my pockets. You deserve what I took.
I promise. I am surprised to see you here.
Hey, Dean. I'm glad you're safe.
How did you get roped into this?
I wasn't forced or anything. I wanted to help.
You are full of surprises, my friend.
Man, what a day, huh?
Hey, listen. I wanted to say thanks. This has been... well, it's been crazy. But I've learned a lot, I think.
Oh. Well, that's good to hear.
You came through it all pretty well, Travis. That's good to hear.
Thanks.
Pretty well? I barely recognize you, Travis.
After all this, I think about the things that had me worried so much, and it just seems silly, you know? Like, was I really that worried about just being on the radio? That's nothing compared to being beaten up, shot at. I can do so much more. And I need to. Anyway, thanks again. I owe you.
Yeah, well, that's a pretty good quest. Yeah, I highly recommend this quest. It's great. So, I guess that's that. Until next time, until I make another episode of Fallout 4 playthrough.